Almighty and eternal God, from whom's love in Christ we cannot be parted, either by death or life, hear our prayers and thanksgivings for all whom we remember this day. Fulfill in them the purpose of your love and bring us all with them to your eternal glory. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. God, our refuge and strength, bring near the day when war shall cease and poverty and pain shall end. The earth may know the peace of heaven through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Richard Blundell, Albert Bond, Hugh Gray, Henry Blackfield, John Carr, George Chapleton, Hugh Chandler, Hugh Gilbert, John Howard, Reginald Howard, Thomas Howard, James Howard, Peter Howard, John Lane, Walter Mayer, John T. Pete, Clifton Ridings, Henry Rimmer, James Rimmer, Nathan Thedden, Arthur Smith, Cyril Sutton, Thomas Waring.
1939-1945. George Burroughs, Reginald Bate, William Ball, John Herbert Carr, Reginald Cowell, Joseph Hart Downs, Robert Gorton, Chris Hyam, John Howard, Jay Hall, Raymond Holson, Robert Millwood, William Kelly, Kenneth Littleford, Arthur Nutter, Stanley Nutter, T. Rimmer, Stuart Rossiter, Harry Seed, Robert Smith, John Waring, Robert Erskine Wilson, M. A. Vlachkowski, Cyprus 1990, Andrew Harry Rimmer.
We shall not grow old as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. The going down of the sun, and in the morning we will remember them.
We will remember them.
When you go home, tell them of us and say for your tomorrow, we gave our today. Ever-living God, we remember those whom you have gathered from the storm of war into the peace of your presence. May that same peace calm our fears, bring justice to all people, and establish harmony among the nations. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
So let us remember before God and commend to his sure keeping those who have died for their country in war, particularly those whom we knew and whose memory we treasure, and all who have lived and died in the service of mankind.
1914 to 1918. Edward Morris Gregson, John Todd, William Hunt, Walter Stanley Rimmer, Harold Cadwell, James Johnson, Harry Wright, Thomas Brookfield Sutton, William Wright, William Riding, Joseph Young, Herbert Leslie Sutton, Thomas Blundell, Harry Berry, Reginald Hyde, James Hosker, John Sutton Waring, Cyril Sutton, John Cadwell, John Howard, James Threlfall, William Herbert Longton, Harold Johnson, Silas Montague Linkletter, John Taylor, William Edward Rothwell, Robert Price, William Kenyon McLachlan, Albert Edward Hammond, Alfred Edward Law, Harold Dyson Wright. 1939 to 1945, George Ainscombe, Leslie Baldwin, Alan Wright, Harry Howard, Philip Wood Tor, John Reginald Howard, Richard Andrews Mould, Samuel Howard, Kenneth Sutton, William Stephen Partington, Harry Taylor, Ernest Bull, William Fairhurst, and in other conflicts, Matthew Titchener.
They shall not grow old as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them. We will remember them.
When you go home, tell them of us and say, for your tomorrow, we gave our today.
During the First World War, on the Ypres salient, there was a small town called Poppering, or Pop, as the British would call it. Pop was home to one Talbot House, a men's club set up by Army chaplains Neville Talbot and P.B. Clayton in 1915. Tuck H, as it was more commonly known as, provided a safe sanctuary for many soldiers who were passing through Poppering to and from the front line. It was ran by Clayton, who went by the name of Tubby, as a centre of rest and relaxation where men could write letters, put on concerts and make friends. Each man who stepped through the doors of Tuck H was treated as an equal, regardless of age, background, and most importantly, of rank. Faith was at the centre of Tuck H, and even after the war, still played a key part in the movement's ethos, which was to love widely, to build bravely, to think fairly, and to witness humbly. At the top of Tuck H, there was a chapel where Tubby would lead worship, perform baptisms or confirmations, and most importantly, offer pastoral support to many an anxious soldier. It was these services that often drew many soldiers through the doors, as Philip Hancock described when writing to Tubby after the war. How well I remember when our division came to Poppering in September 1917 to be in readiness for the Passchendaele offensive. On the Sunday evening, about six of us, all pals, were looking for a service somewhere and happened on Talbot House. What a wonderful home-like atmosphere the place had. We were told by some other Tommies on entering that the little room upstairs was crowded out and we should not be able to attend the service. We were just on the point of turning away, disappointed, when we saw you making your way down the staircase, packed with fellows. "Don't go away, boys. We are having a second house. There will be a second service." So we waited, and thank God we did. The memory of that quiet Sunday evening service helped so many of us over many dreadful and difficult days which followed in that awful month of Saint-Julien and Langemarck. Some of the boys went under, but their last days were cheered and their hearts made glad by the messages of Tuck H. And we talked of these things in our dugout afterwards.
So the words of the blessing. God grant the living grace, to the departed rest, to the people of every church and nation peace and concord, and to us and all the servants of God life everlasting. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always. Amen. Gathered here this morning as an act of remembrance to remember the fallen of thanks. And we'll begin our time together by the laying of the wreaths, and then we will have the names of the fallen read out, followed by the salutation, the last post, and I call all of us then to observe the 2 minute silence, followed by Rivali, Maya Prayer, Maya Kumbima, Epitaph, and the Blessing.
And so we remember those of this village who died in the Great War of 1914 to 1918. George Howard, Henry Howard, Richard Abram, Thomas Riding, John Thompson, William Francis, Robert Brookfield, John Blundell, Robert Blundell, M.M., Herbert Baxter, Hugh Braid, James Hall, Lawrence Abram, Thomas Waring, Stephen Waring, William Howard, Robert Baxter, Thomas Howard, and Richard Pete. And we remember those who died in the Second World War of 1939 to 1945. Edward Abram, Robert Holdsworth, Moses Alton, Thomas Howard, Albert Ball, William Idden, William Bond, Kenneth Littleford, James Gerard, Henry Parkinson, and John Pennington Wolfenden.
They shall not grow old as we who are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn, at the going down of the sun, and in the morning we will remember them.
We will remember them.
Thank you. Let us pray. As we gather together as one family, to reflect today on the horrors of the past that continue to haunt humanity and darken our world, we give thanks for the sacrifices made by our armed forces, those valiant hearts, in every generation, in the pursuit of freedom, justice, and peace, and for the prospect of building a better future for us all. Lord, where pain still overwhelms, bring healing. Where hearts are still breaking, bring comfort. Where peoples are still oppressed, bring liberation. Where communities are still victimized, bring justice. Where children are still brutalized, bring compassion. Where lives are still crushed, bring hope. Where evil is perpetuated, bring repentance. Where war still devastates, bring peace. Most of all, wherever a single voice cries out in the darkness, bring us to one another in the name of the love you bear in your heart for all people, all nations, and all creation, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
When you go home, tell them of us and say, for your tomorrow we gave our today. God grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to the Church, the Queen and the Commonwealth and all people, unity, peace and concord, and to us and all God's servants, life everlasting. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be with us, remain with us, this day and always. Amen. Amen.